Thank you, Dr. Shayma. Second speaker, Dr. Mohamed Agina from Azhar University, who will talk about comparative study between endovenous laser ablation and CET for treatment of lower limb varicose vein.
Comparative study between endovenous laser ablation and ECAT in treatment of lower limb varicose vein. Introduction, aim of the work, patient method, result, conclusions. What is the ideal treatment of varicose vein? Chronic venous disease is most common disorder of peripheral vascular system. Endovenous or open surgery for varicose vein is commonly performed for indications that range from cosmetic concern in young or middle-aged women to treatment of extensive ulceration in elderly patients. It is essential that patients are well informed about possible risk, discomfort, restriction before making their decision. What do you think? Endovenous laser ablation or ECAT? What is the ideal treatment and can achieve great outcome? Endovenous laser ablation, one day surgery, early recovery, but what about subfemoral incompetence, labial varicosity, leg ulcers, complex pathology, dips from the skin, tumescent, second look, young age, recurrence, cost, and residual varicosity, and intraoperative doublex? Aim of the work, comparative study between endovenous laser ablation and ECAT in treatment of lower limb varicose vein. Patient methods, the study was conducted upon 50 patients presented with primary lower limb varicose vein from November 2017 till December 2018 at Al-Azhar University Hospital. 50 patients, 31 male and 19 female, 3 patients was presented by venous ulcer. Exclusion criteria, refuse operative procedure after informed consent. Bilateral lower limb edema, infected or inflamed limb, infected ulcer, ischemic lower limb, acute deep venous thrombosis, chronic DVT, incompetent deep system, recent history of pulmonary embolism, pregnancy, and allergy to bleedocanol. All patients subjected to two clinical evaluations, routine lab investigation, duplex assessment of venous system, diameter of great saphenous vein, mapping of saphenofemoral junction, saphenopopliteal, and great saphenous vein immediately preoperative. Endovenous laser ablation, we performed under duplex guidance. Venous access was obtained while patient in supine position, sometimes reversed Trendenberg position. Then we introduced laser fiber into the sheath by the aid of ultrasound. The castor tip was positioned just about 2 cm away from saphenofemoral junction. The access site is 10 cm below knee. Laser fiber are conducted to generators. Location of the castor tip was confirmed by detection of a specific light beam present at the tip of the castor that can be seen under the skin. Duplex ultrasound was used for injection of tumescent anesthesia along course of great saphenous vein below saphenous fascia and above deep muscular fascia to surround the vein. The laser fiber was conducted to device and the fiber was activated while withdrawing the fiber and speed that was allowing adequate thermal ablation of great saphenous vein. Treated part of vein are compressed manually during energy delivery. Finally, sheath was removed from the vein, allowing complete thermal ablation of all selected segment of great saphenous vein. ECAT, informed consent of other routine preoperative preparation, supine position, Trendenberg operation is done under local anesthesia. This picture show groin incision, saphenofemoral disconnection, ligation of all tributary. Puncture of great saphenous vein and torto medial malleus under local filtration anesthesia. Guide wire is located to vein lumen. Correct position of the sheath is controlled. Introducing fire to till groin, then castor, remove the wire, withdrawal of the castor 2 cm from saphenous stem. Close it under vision. Closure of wound and sterile dressing is applied, but gauze is put all over the course of great saphenous vein. Crepe bandage or graduated compression is applied to groin. air foam 1 to 4 polluted canal to air ratio by volume, 0.5 milli polluted canal at syringe plus 2 millimeter air at syringe 3 millimeter making foam, and inject 2.5 millimeter foam for every 15 centimeter of length of great saphenous vein, while withdrawal of the castor at speed of 15 centimeter per minute for complete distribution of foam to vein endothelium. This picture shows preparation and injection of foam in great saphenous vein. Repeat injection during castor withdrawn with maximum volume 15 cm at limb till removal of the castor and sheath. Complete bed rest at first 6 hours. Return to daily activity at second day. Bandage at operative theater is continuous at first week. Results as regards ECAT after first week, clinical duplex evaluation, post-operative, remove stitch, rapid removal, rapid recovery, mild edema and redness, 5 patients a course of great saphenous vein, mild vein especially with full extension of the knee, focal thrombophore bites about 2 cm at 3 patients around the knee. After 1 month, it's appear of these symptoms and duplex follow-up show marked reduction of diameter of great saphenous vein, 2 to 3 mm without patent segment recanalization or active thrombosis. No neuritis, no skin complications, ulcer decrease in size without infection and the complete health 3 weeks to 6 weeks. 60 patients need foam sclerotherapy for an outpatient clinic. This picture immediately post-operative, and this patient underwent for ECAT 1 week after surgery. This patient, female patient, 35 year, underwent for ECAT 1 year ago, and the duplex show ligated subfemoral junction ligation and sclerosed great saphenous vein. This picture show patient with venous ulcer pre-ECAT and 2 weeks after ECAT, 1 month after ECAT, 6 weeks after ECAT. While 25 patients underwent for endovenous laser ablation of period of 1 year, clinical and duplex follow-up after one week, there is mild edema, ecchymosis, redness, 10 patients at course of great saphenous vein and pain, especially with full extension of the knee. Focal thrombophlebitis at 10 patients around the knee, 3 cases of skin ulcerations below the knee, and 2 cases of nerve injury below knee, 15 cases of residual varicosity need injection sclerotherapy. And after 1 year follow-up, it's 6 cases of partial occluded great saphenous vein. Conclusion, individualization and observation is a golden rule. Saphenous vein ablation may replace great venous trapping with single procedure without Hindenburg operation, may increase risk of recurrence, especially in young age. So ECAT is one operation may use zero recurrence, short-term recurrence, and can improve all drawbacks of conventional surgery and have advantage of endovenous ablation. ECAT is done under local anesthesia with cost effectiveness, cosmetic result, and early recovery. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mohamed, for this presentation. But I have a comment and a question. The first comment اللي هو في التايتل المفروض لما بتحط تايتل لازم تحطه بالاختصار بتاعه. يعني طبعا الإيكات ديت ما تنفعش تحط كتايتل في برزنتيشن خاصة إذا كان كومبيتيشن برزنتيشن لازم تكتب وبعد كده تحط الاختصار. لأن ده تحتمل كذا تأويل يعني كله أعتقد ما كانش عارف إن دي الإندوفينوس كيميكال ابليشن وستريندر بيج اوبيشن ده اختصار ما هوش انترناشونال يعني. الحاجة الثانية ان انت عملت ميكسد بتوين كومبليتلي اندوفينوس تكنيك مع هايبريد يعني في سيرجيكال تكنيك مع ان ممكن الاندوفينوس كيميكال ابليشن دي بتتم وزاوت تريندر بيج اوبريشن يعني نفس الطريقة اللي بتعمل بيها الليزر بتعمل كومبريشن بالدوبلكس وبتعمل انجكشن اوف فوم اوف كريلوثيرابي مع الكومبريشن عشان ما يدخلش على الديب سيستم لمده 2 مينتس من غير ما تعمل لان انت دلوقتي حطيت كومبليتلي اندوفينوس مع هايبريد تكنيك فكده الكوزموزيس اختلف بالنسبه للبيشنت هنا والبيشنت اللي ما استخدمتلوش حاجه ثانيه. واخد بالك؟
تمام بس what about بقى ال recurrence and liver varicosity؟ احنا بنعمل disconnection عشان نمنع يعني لو في liver varicosity مثلا.
انت جاست ان انت عملت complete obliteration للسفينوفيمورال جنكشن الليبيال varicosity دي بتقل بعد كده وزود disconnection ليها.
تريبيوتري بس اكسترنال بيودندل ما هو مازال برضه مفتوح ده اللي احنا
شايفينه. قفلت انت السفينو فيمورال بالانجكشن بتاعك لكن ممكن تعمل لها دايركت اتاك
من غير او انجكشن سكليروثيرابي منفصله عنها. يعني انا بتكلم على تكنيك فيها هايبريد ميثود، ان انت عملت الترندبرج اوبريشن وفي الوقت نفسه عملت انجكشن. الحاجه الثانيه برضو في الكومباريزون، ان انت حطيت هنا كومبريشن ثيرابي واضح في حالات الكيميكال ابليشن وما كانش موجود في الليزر، ويو كانت انهانس او يو كانت جرانتي هو ميكينج ذا هيلينج اوف ذيس ألسر، ذا كومبريشن ثيرابي اور يور تكنيك اللي هو الابليشن ثيرابي، على عكس الليزر ان هو انت بتعتمد على ميثود واحده بس اللي هو الاندوفينس ابليشن والليزر. فبالتالي برضو الكومباريتيف ما هوش فير في الاثنين.
نعمل كومبريشن في الليزر برضو، بس ده يعني كومبريشن في الليزر وكومبريشن في الايكيات برضو.
لكن في الليزر، في الليزر انت ما علقتش على ان هو كان فور هاو لونج والطريقه اللي استخدمتها في الكومبريشن.
تمام
بس شكرا دكتور محمد.